Hi, I'm Jessica Scandura, and I'm going to be introducing the counting sequence. In kindergarten, students are expected to count from 0 to 100, as well as count by tens. In first grade, we extend that to counting to 120. Second graders count all the way to 1,000, both by ones, twos, fives, tens, and hundreds. In order to help students meet these goals, we have them count both forwards and backwards, starting from zero, counting 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way to 100 in kindergarten, or 120 in first grade. But we also have them count from a different number, like 25, and starting at 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and extending that. Students also do the same thing counting backwards, starting both from 100 and starting from various starting points. Students not only need to count orally, but also they need to start learning how to count sets of objects as well. Students use one-to-one correspondence to touch each object as they count. For example, they would count these bears, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When students master this, they're given objects in a more random order, and their expectation is that they will line them up, and then again use one-to-one correspondence to count all the objects in the set. Another tool that we use is the hundreds chart or the 120 chart. A hundred chart would go from 1 to 100, and this 120 chart goes from 1 all the way to 120. Students use this to help them count forwards. They can touch each number as they count. They can also use it to count backwards and touch each number as they count. But it's also a great tool for learning skip counting. Students can count by tens, 10, 20, 30, 40. They can also count by fives, 5, 10, 15, 20. And they can use it to count by tens off of what we call these decade numbers, such as counting 7, 17, 27.